All right, so the plan here is, I'm pretty much just gonna take this balloon and right at the car, and hopefully it works. Dude, I feel like that broke his windshield. Oh my gosh, what if it did?
Dude, I don't know if that's a good idea.
No.
I thought the windshield was done.
Good thing you didn't even go that fast.
This is what I walk out and see him doing to my car. What are you doing?
I'm impregnating your car, Bryce. This is how five of us were born.
Just shoving a big balloon in there.
Yeah, you ready for the pull-out game?
Yep. Oh, she is on her monthly.
Caress it like a baby.
Come on, you got the eggplant baby, bro? You got the eggplant baby, bro? Can you handle that much glizzy, Bryce? The glizzy master himself.
Oh, yeah. What would you do if you just seen this coming at you?
Dude, I'm running.
I feel like it's gonna pop if I lay it on the hood. We must see if we can hold it.
Oh! My phone! No! My wallet! Fuck! What's up, everybody? Here we have the hood to the Firebird, and we're gonna take a step in a different direction with this car. And what we're gonna do is, instead of doing motor work and everything, we're gonna do a little body work. You can see this paint is not in great condition. The clear coat is just gone. There's bare metal right here. Paint is all gone off of it. It's a little glossy down there where the paint kind of still lives, but it's not in good condition. What we're gonna do is, we're gonna try to repaint it with a metallic gray. It's a Chrysler color, but we thought it looked pretty neat. And we're probably gonna replace the hood anyways down the road, but for now we're gonna repaint it. See how good of a job we can do. Of course, we have to sand it, primer it, put our base coat down, and our clear coat. A couple other things you're gonna need is a scuffing pad. We have 800 grit. Any lint, debris, you know, just make it nice and smooth before we put our base coat down. Then we have a tack cloth. It's gonna be super smooth. So after we put our primer down, we'll be able to rub, get any imperfections out, you know, get any lint, dust, anything that's on it before we put our actual paint. We have grease and wax remover, so after we sand it, we can clean it, make it nice and ready for primer. Glass cleaner, which is water-based, and we have microfiber cloth. But first step is to get sanding. So we're gonna begin with an 800 grit sandpaper, and we don't have an electric or air-powered sander. All right, we're gonna clean this off first. It's pretty dusty. So now I'm on a 1000 grit sandpaper, and we're not taking it down to bare metal everywhere. We only took it down to bare metal in parts where we just had no choice because it was too rough. There was a little bit of rust, surface rust, or we just had a rough area like this where we had to get it down to bare metal. But now we have it nice and smooth. You feel nothing when you run your hand over it. We're using 1000 grit, like I said, to make it nice and, what'd you say?
I said,
what? Nice and as smooth as a baby's. Why is there so many cars going by?
Smooth like a baby's butt.
Yes, sir. Well, we're gonna keep making it nice and smooth with this 1000 grit, and we're gonna
go to 1500.
Clean it. You're right. We are gonna go to 1500 grit after this, and then make it perfect, no flaws, nothing in it anywhere. Cause I don't feel anything over here.
I say we do 1,000, 1,500, then the 2,000.
No, there's no reason to do 2,000. It's way too smooth. Okay. I mean, we do, because we're supposed to just do 1,200 highest.
Oh.
We're going to do 1,000 and hit it with the 15 and we'll be good. I think, anyways. Unless you really want to hit it with the 2,000, but.
I mean, what else are we going to use it for? Paint windows.
You so can smooth. You can do it. But after we're done sanding, we're going to clean it with glass cleaner. And that,
we're going to do that tomorrow or do it today and tomorrow?
No, we'll finish sanding and we'll clean it tonight. And then we'll do primer in the morning. Next, you're going to take your 800 grit scuffing pad, which in our case is 800. I'm not sure how much it matters. And then we're going to go around the entire edge of the hood and over the entire top surface. Make sure we're hitting it really good, nice and even. Make sure there's no rough edges. Anything we need to look out for, we're getting it with these two.
I did the edges last.
All right, here we have our hood all hung up off the ceiling. And yes, we don't have a paint booth. We have a metal wire hanging onto the hood and it is just floating above. It don't matter. Matthew's hitting it with glass cleaner right now and it is water-based glass cleaner. So I don't know the reason for it being water-based, but that's what we were told to use. He's gonna clean it, get any lint imperfections out of it that we want out of it before we begin to spray the primer on it.
I'm using a grease and wax remover to clean the hood. I'm just dabbing a little bit on the towel and I'm holding it. I'm just spreading it along the entire surface of the hood, as well as the edges and all the corners. I'm just spreading it, thinning it out as much as I can, making sure there's no oils from our hands touching it. Nothing we'll need to worry about, and our primer will stick. It's pretty much dry. And I am using a microfiber, of course. You're not gonna use your regular bath towel on any of your paint or car cleaning tasks.
Get a feel of this. This feels like some nasty skin.
Oh, dude, yeah. That's like, oh my gosh.
Yeah, so I've never touched one of these before. But we're going to take our tack cloth and we're going to attack the surface. Make sure there's no lint, debris, anything that could be in the paint. And pretty much get it ready for primer. Here we have Duplicolor filler primer. So what it's going to do is you're going to spray on the entire surface, get a good nice covering over the entire hood, and then that's what your base coat will go on this. And our little secret weapon here, instead of sitting here fingering it and hoping we can get accurate, I'm going to pop this lid off. I think we use a screwdriver, and that's all. I man-powered it. Yeet. And basically how these work is you just kind of finesse it onto the gun and kaboom, you now have a weapon of mass destruction. So we're gonna do a little test spray on this, just to make sure it's gonna work right. I'm gonna hold this box out. And just like that, we have our gun ready to paint. That primer's gonna stink, but it's gonna get things done. So let's get it. Thank you. What's up, guys? As you can see, the hood is completely primed, and you may notice that there's like lines all in it. And let me explain, you know, because as with everything we do in life, we have problems. It's very smooth, looks great, but let me explain. So what happened was, we bought two cans of primer because we thought two cans would cover the entire hood. Here's what went wrong. So we ran out of the first can and it was a dark prime gray, right? And then we went to the second can, it was a lighter gray. Can you see that line right there? Well, you can kind of see there's like lighter gray, darker gray. And that doesn't look very, that doesn't look like we did a good job. It looks kind of blotchy and there's a lot of spots all in it. It doesn't look very well done. If you look at it with different ways of light, you can see all of it actually. And you can see just the bad spots in it. This is the can, and this is the other can. They're exactly the same. There's nothing different. And they came out different colors. Very slight difference, but we noticed it, and I'm sure you guys can see that too. It just doesn't look all that great. I mean, look at that. But onto a different topic. The primer is not that bad. We're gonna finish it in the morning. We're gonna tack cloth it again, make sure it's ready for more primer, clean it, primer it, make sure it's ready, and then we're gonna use 1,000 grit or 800 grit sandpaper, smooth the primer out, tack cloth it, clean it, prep it for the base coat, and guys, let me show you something. So this is the color that we went with. It's a dark gray metallic, and we did a test spray on this box right here, and yeah, I know it's on cardboard, and look how great it turned out. Like, this is on a piece of cardboard, and so it's very rough textured, but just how nice the paint is. Sparkly, it's very clean, you know, it looks good, and that's what we want. And that's on a rough surface. You can see all the rough area in here, you know. Whoa, it's still a little wet, but on a smooth hood, it's gonna look great.
ATL, Jacob, ATL, Jacob. Yeah, yeah, HiTek Tek, yeah, yeah. Big old jet, yeah, yeah. Big ass chick, yeah, yeah. Big old bitch, yeah, yeah. Thick little shit, yeah, yeah. I'm getting my money, yeah, yeah. I'm getting this rich, yeah, yeah. Straight out the print, yep. I'm straight out the trench, yep. I'm straight out the trench, yep. I'm straight out the trench, yep. Bitch, into the trench, ooh. It's back on the floor.